Hello and welcome to In Depth. I'm Tina Jha. Starting 1st December, all four-wheelers in India must have FASTag radio frequency identification stickers on their windscreen to make payments at toll plazas on all national highways across the country. This means that from next month onwards, toll payments will be made only through FASTags under the National Electronic Toll Collection Program. The Pan India program is intended to remove bottlenecks and ensure seamless movement of traffic on all national highways. In cases of non-compliance, double the toll amount will be charged for travelling through FASTag lanes without these tags. There will, of course, be a hybrid lane as well, where the usual toll will be charged from non-FASTag vehicles. In this edition of In Depth, we try and understand what is FASTag and how does it work? Where and how can you get these FASTags for your four-wheelers? What documents are required to get them? And yet, of course, the many benefits of using a FASTag, that's also what we're going to talk about on the program today. So crossing toll plazas will no more be the same from 1st December, as the Ministry of Road Transport and Highways will make it mandatory for all vehicles to have FASTags affixed on windscreens of all four-wheelers. The NHAI is providing FASTags free of cost as the 1st December deadline fast approaches. Here is a detailed report about these FASTags.
Starting December 1st, you will have to pay twice the toll amount for passing through FASTag lanes at toll plazas on all national highways in case you do not have the FASTags on your vehicles. Road Transport and Highways Minister Nitin Gadkari said on 21st November that starting next month, toll payments will be made only through FASTags under the National Electronic Toll Collection Program, which is the flagship initiative of the Ministry of Road Transport and Highways. Around 537 toll plazas have become 100% electronic toll collection compliant, including 17 where FASTags will be read through handheld devices. For its promotion, the National Highways Authority of India has set up more than 2,000 centres across the country where people can get RFID tags for free till 30th November, with NHAI spending around 200 crore rupees for the same.
देश की जनता को आह्वान करता हूं कि वो लगाए और उसके बारे में जो फॉर्मेलिटी वो पूरी करे ताकि आपको आगे निश्चित रूप से किसी प्रकार की तकलीफ नहीं होगी। एक बात जरूर है कि 1 दिसंबर के बाद अगर आपके पास टोल में घुस गया और आपके पास फास्टैग नहीं होगा तो आपको दुगना टोल देना पड़ेगा। इसकी भी प्रयोजन की गई है, इसलिए आज आपसे अनुरोध है कि आप अपने गाड़ी पर ये फ्री ऑफ चार्ज मिल रहा है पूरे देश की ऑटोमोबाइल में जो ट्रक ओनर्स है, बस ओनर्स है, कार ओनर्स है, टेम्पो या मिनी ट्रक ओनर्स है, जो इनको सबको मेरा आह्वान है कि वो तुरंत हमारी इस स्कीम का फायदा ले और लगा ले।
FASTag is presented as the perfect solution for a hassle-free trip on our national highways. FASTag is presently operational at 180 toll plazas across national and state highways. More toll plazas will be brought under the FASTag program in the near future.
FASTag is a unique way for people who are travelling, who have to cross various toll plazas. Now, we know these are days where one has to pay lots of tolls at highways, different points on highways. Till now, people had the option of paying it in cash. Now, it is sort of being made mandatory that you have to use FASTag or you pay higher amount.
FASTag is a simple to use reloadable tag that enables automatic deduction of toll charges and lets one pass through the toll plaza without stopping for a cash transaction. FASTag is linked to a prepaid account from which the applicable toll amount will get deducted. The tag employs radio frequency identification or RFID technology and is affixed on the vehicle's windscreen after the tag account is active. FASTag is also vehicle specific, and once it is affixed to a vehicle, it cannot be transferred to another vehicle. It can be purchased from any of the National Electronic Toll Collection member banks. If a FASTag is linked to a prepaid account, then it needs to be recharged as per the usage of the customer. If adequate balance is not maintained by the customer, the FASTag gets blacklisted at toll plazas. In such a scenario, if the customer travels through a toll plaza without recharging, then he or she won't be able to avail the NETC services and would be required to pay the toll fare using cash.
बहुत ज़्यादा आसानी हमारे लिए, क्योंकि हमारे को रुकना पड़ता था और पैसे ऐसे के लिए लफड़ा होता था, लड़ाइयाँ भी रोज होती हैं, इसलिए अपना फास्टैग ऐसा है महीने के लिए रिचार्ज कराओ, उसके बाद सीधा अपना निकल जाओ।
फास्टैग लेने में अराउंड 15 मिनट लगे हैं और इसके फायदे ये हैं कि सपोज उनके पास छुट्टे होते नहीं हैं, इतनी लंबी कतारें लगती हैं, तो वो सारी चीज़ें बहुत ईजिली हो जाएंगी, कम समय पर हो जाएगा।
इवन द टॉल प्लाजा नीड नॉट एम्प्लॉय टू मेनी पीपल टू ऑपरेट बिकॉज द इलेक्ट्रॉनिक इंटरफेस विल बी कलेक्टिंग द मनी. So you don't have to have people in each and every gate who will be issuing a ticket and then opening the gate, etc. That will not be necessary. They even now enter the vehicle number on their computer counter to give you a ticket. So all the time will be saved.
One can buy a FASTag from select banks including SBI, HDFC Bank, ICICI Bank, Axis Bank among others, and also through point of sale counters at National Highway toll plazas. Since the FASTag is linked to an account, KYC documentation would be required as per the KYC policy of the issuer bank. Apart from the KYC documentation, one needs to submit the registration certificate or RC of the vehicle when applying for a FASTag. However, if the FASTag is linked to a prepaid account, then it can be issued as per the following limits. A limited KYC FASTag account holder cannot have more than 20,000 rupees in their FASTag prepaid account. The monthly reload limit is also capped at 20,000 rupees. The documents required are minimum KYC details as per the issuer bank policy, the vehicle's RC copy, photo of the customer, and limits prescribed by the RBI till 30th December. The full KYC FASTag account holder cannot have more than 1 lakh rupees in their FASTag prepaid account. There is no monthly reload cap on this account. Documents required include full KYC details as per issuer bank policy, the vehicle's RC copy and photo of the customer.
लाने के लिए नॉर्मल डॉक्यूमेंट्स चाहिए अपने को, एक आरसी की कॉपी चाहिए, पैन कार्ड चाहिए, आधार चाहिए, आधार कार्ड चाहिए, क्योंकि वो केवाईसी कराते हैं.
Now when people are buying a new car, the RFID enabled FASTag already comes fitted to your car because the dealer is supposed to give you the car with a RFID tag fitted. Suppose you have a old car. Now you want to have a FASTag in that. You can go to any of the car dealers and ask them. And this involves getting your KYC. Know your customer details, that is like your ID, your address proof, etc. to be given. And account is given to you with an account number and a chip is fitted on your car. So then you have to recharge it, keep enough money so that it gets automatically deducted as you travel through as many toll plazas as possible.
FASTags are part of the National Electronic Toll Collection or NETC program developed by the National Payments Corporation of India. According to NPCI, as many as 9.67 lakh transactions were processed daily through FASTags across all toll plazas on national highways in India in the month of September, which is a total of 34% of all transactions done by vehicles commuting on national highways. With input from Anu Diwan and Vipul Agarwal, Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
FASTags employed radio frequency identification or RFID technology to make toll payments directly while the vehicle is in motion. Although RFID technology has been in use since the Second World War, the demand for RFID equipment is now increasing rapidly. So let's find out what is the technology and what are its potentials.
RFID or radio frequency identification refers to a technology whereby digital data encoded in RFID tags or smart labels are captured by a reader via radio waves. The tag contains electronically stored information. RFID is similar to barcoding in that data from a tag or label are captured by a device that stores it in a database. Although more expensive to use than the barcode stickers, RFID has many advantages over systems that use barcode asset tracking software. The most notable being that RFID tag data can be read outside the line of sight, whereas barcodes must be aligned with an optical scanner. An RFID tagging system includes the tag itself, a read or write device, a host system application for data collection, processing, and transmission. There are two types of RFID tags, active and passive. Tags that contain their own power source are known as active tags. Those without a power source are known as passive tags. A passive tag is briefly activated by the radio frequency scan of the RFID reader. The electrical current is small, generally just enough for transmission of an ID number. Active tags have more memory and can be read at greater ranges.
Radio frequency identification, RFID technology. A small chip is placed on the car. This identifies the car and enables payment of road toll, tax, etc. without actually involving any physical payment. So therefore, digital payment can be made using the FASTag technology.
RFID belongs to a group of technologies referred to as Automatic Identification and Data Capture, or AIDC. AIDC methods automatically identify objects, collect data about them, and enter that data directly into computer systems with little or no human intervention. RFIDs utilize radio waves to accomplish this. At a simple level, RFID systems consists of three components: an RFID tag or smart label, an RFID reader, and an antenna. RFID tags contain an integrated circuit and an antenna, which are used to transmit data to the RFID reader. The reader then converts the radio waves to a more usable form of data. Information collected from the tags is then transferred through a communications interface to a host computer system, where the data can be stored in a database and analyzed at a later time. Besides their use in FASTags, RFID tags have many other applications. The technology is used in many industries to perform various tasks, including inventory management, asset tracking, personnel tracking, controlling access to restricted areas, ID badging, supply chain management, and counterfeit prevention, like in the pharmaceutical industry. Although RFID technology has been in use since World War II, the demand for RFID equipment is now increasing rapidly. With inputs from Vipul Agarwal, Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
And time for a short break here, but on the other side, we'll talk about the benefits of these FASTags. Do stay with us. Welcome back, you're watching In Depth. So as we told you earlier in the program, that FASTags will become mandatory for all vehicles, private and commercial, starting 1st December 2019. Now these FASTags are currently being issued by 22 certified banks through various channels at national highway toll plazas as well as bank branches. Let's now take a look at some common queries related to FASTags.
What are the benefits of using FASTag?
Ease of payment, no need to carry cash for toll transactions, which saves time. Option of online recharge, SMS alerts for toll transactions and low balance. Online portal for customers to keep track and manage activity, and a validity of 5 years.
What are the KYC documents required to apply for FASTag for corporate vehicles?
In case of proprietorship, PAN card of the proprietor, address proof of the proprietor, shop act or other firm proof will be required. In case of a public limited, private limited or partnership company, PAN card of the corporate, photo ID of the signing authority, the list of directors with addresses, names and addresses of partners, the certificate of incorporation or the partnership deed, or the registration certificate of the firm will be needed.
What are the charges for FASTag?
FASTag has a one-time fee of 200 rupees. The refundable security deposit depends on the vehicle type and is listed on websites of the issuer agencies.
Is there a minimum value for recharge?
The minimum recharge amount is 100 rupees.
Can a FASTag bought for one vehicle be used for another vehicle?
Separate FASTags are issued for separate vehicles. FASTag is issued to each vehicle based on KYC documents submitted. If a FASTag, for instance, bought for one car is used for a truck, then such a FASTag shall get blacklisted. This will result in denial of vehicle passage from FASTag lanes on all toll plazas.
Can one vehicle use more than one FASTag?
It is strictly prohibited to purchase two FASTags for one vehicle. In case of multiple FASTags, customers will be responsible for operational issues. In case of relocation to another city, FASTag will work on all enabled toll plazas. In case of change in city or address, the customer needs to inform the issuer agency. In case of a car being sold or transferred, the issuer agency needs to be informed.
What to do if the FASTag is lost? What will happen to the account balance?
The customer care of the issuer agency has to be contacted to block a lost FASTag. Once a new account is allocated, the issuer agency will transfer the balance to a new account.
How can I block a FASTag account in case of lost vehicle?
The customer can call up customer care of the issuer agency and block their FASTag account.
What do I do if the FASTag gets damaged?
The vehicle owner or user could approach the issuer agency for replacement of FASTag.
How can I know if the correct user fee has been deducted from a FASTag account?
The customer will receive an SMS alert in their registered phone number each time an amount is deducted from their FASTag account. Fee payable on each toll plaza may be seen on www.nhtis.org in addition to being displayed at concerned toll plazas.
How do I report an incorrect deduction and get a refund?
A customer can report an incorrect deduction by calling the customer care number of the issuer agency. The agency will then review the request and take necessary action.
Can the tags purchased earlier be used?
Only RFID tags purchased earlier can be used, as any other type of tag will not work on FASTag lanes.
On which highways or roads FASTag can be used?
FASTag is presently operational at 520 plus toll plazas across national highways. The list of toll plazas and roads is available online.
How do I get my FASTag checked or rectified to see whether it is active or not?
A customer can raise a request by calling the customer care of the respective issuer agency, or they can refer to steps under the standard operating procedure for FASTag user.
What if the vehicle owner or user has a grievance?
The primary point of contact for the vehicle owner or user is the issuer agency, contact details for which will be shared at the time of FASTag issuance. Indian Highways Management Company Limited can be approached at the next level.
In recent times, toll plazas have been the news for all the wrong reasons. Attendants being beaten up, slowing moving lines of vehicles, traffic congestion, and frustrated drivers. While FASTags offer an efficient solution to these problems, let's find out what are the other challenges in effective toll plaza management.
Long queues could lead to short fuses. Limited number of toll booths and long waiting time not only waste fuel of idling vehicles, they also irritate and frustrate the drivers. The anger often spilling over as verbal spats and physical fights. In many cases, toll attendants are at the receiving end simply because drivers do not want to pay. Manning toll gates in such instances is hazardous occupation for attendants.
When there are large number of cars going, like the example we saw, Delhi-Jaipur highway, where in Gurgaon toll plaza, there have been many times violence and riots because of long waiting time. So all this will be avoided. Similarly, there are many highways in India, like for example, Mumbai, Pune, Chennai, Puducherry, etc., where there's a lot of movement. Now even Delhi-Lucknow, Lucknow-Agra, getting a lot of traffic. All these highways with a lot of traffic intensity will benefit.
The efficiency of any toll gate system is measured by the length of queues of the waiting vehicles. Faster the clearance, the better the system. Another huge problem in toll collection is local resistance. Sometimes people do not want to pay. It could be due to a political party spearheading a protest to assert the right of local residents to use a road, or drivers becoming angry over the poor operation and indifferent maintenance of the roads they are using. While electronic tolling, FASTags and radio frequency identification device or RFID technology offer efficient solutions, road users also point to various challenges. A common one cropping up with users who are not used to plastic money. There is also the issue of interoperability in toll plazas and the absence of a seamless platform for traffic data, toll collection and charging. There are challenges and apprehensions of using FASTag itself. A common concern is that of drivers apprehending loss of their FASTags due to theft or other reasons. Another fear is when toll charges are wrongly deducted due to technical error or scanners not detecting them. Sometimes drivers even complain of waiting in FASTag lanes longer due to non-FASTag vehicles also getting into the queue. But given the multiple advantages, including the reduced handling of cash by users as well as authorities running toll plazas, FASTags are an ideal situation to reduce the rush, the waiting time, and of course, the resultant congestion, fuel consumption and pollution. With inputs from Vipul Agarwal, Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
Well, so that's it from us in this edition of In Depth. We'll see you same time next week now with a focus on another key subject. You can also watch our program online on YouTube and Twitter. And of course, you can also send in your valuable feedback and suggestions about our program. Thank you for your time.